हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ प्रोफेसर एन एस पासवर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर बॉटनी, के ऑफ कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर नासिक। सो टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक दैट इज प्लांट ग्रोथ रेगुलेटर्स। सो प्लांट ग्रोथ रेगुलेटर्स इज नथिंग बट इट इज द ऑर्गेनिक सब्सटेंस विच आर नेचुरली सिंथेसाइज इन द प्लांट एंड दे इन्फ्लुएंस द ग्रोथ एंड डेवलपमेंट ऑफ ए प्लांट फ्रॉम द रिमोट ऑफ देयर साइट ऑफ सिंथेसिस। दिस इज वी कॉल्ड एज ए plant growth regulator, or it is we call as a plant hormone. So particularly these different types of the behavioral patterns and functions of the plants is controlled by the hormone, and these chemical messengers, they are influence the growth and development of a plant. And this plant hormone, they are naturally synthesized substance, they are produced by the plant, and these substances, they are acts to control the plant activities through chemical messengers. So this is called as a plant growth regulator or plant hormone. Then these particularly plant growth regulators are produced in one part of a plant, and then they are transported to other parts where they initiate a response or they initiate the action. They are stored in regions where stimulates and then released for transport through either phloem or mesophyll when the appropriate stimulus is occurs. Particularly these plant hormones or this plant growth regulator, they are synthesized at a site and then they transported from this synthesis site to action site through mesophyll cell or through when the particular that stimulus is appear. Then what is the meaning of plant growth regulator? So it includes plant hormones, both that is natural and synthetic, but also include non-nutrient chemicals not found naturally in plants that when applied to plants influence their growth and development. So collectively we called as a plant growth regulator. So in the plant growth regulator, both are coming, that is plant hormones, both natural and synthetic, and also some non-nutrient chemicals which are not naturally present in plant, they are also categorized as a plant growth regulator. So plant growth regulator is a broad category. So there are five recognized groups of natural plant hormones and growth regulators. So these five categories are, first one is that is auxin, second one is gibberellin, third one is cytokinin, fourth one is ethylene, and fifth one is abscisic acid. So first three, that is auxin, gibberellin and cytokinin, are called as growth promoting hormones or growth promoter. And last two one, that is ethylene and abscisic acid, is called as growth retardant or growth inhibiting hormones. Then plant growth and development are under the control of two sets of internal factors. So these factors are nothing but a nutritional factors, particularly such as the supply of that is carbohydrates, proteins, fats and other constituents which are the raw material required for the growth. And secondly, whatever this that is the organic substances, that is carbohydrates, proteins, fats and other constituents which are synthesized, they use these organic substances for the formation of that is the plant hormones or the vitamins. So proper utilization of these raw materials is under the control of certain chemical messengers which can be classified into hormones and vitamins. So what is the difference between hormones and vitamins? So hormone, the site of synthesis of hormone is different from the site of action. So particularly the hormones which are synthesized in the plant, the site of synthesis and the site of action is different in case of hormone. Then in case of vitamin, the vitamins are used in the same part without being transported. So whatever the vitamins, they are synthesized in the part of the plant, they are utilized at the plant where they are synthesized. So they are not transported from one place to the another place. And second difference is that plant hormones are physiologically active. So they are going the physiological response. But in case of vitamins are themselves are not physiologically active, but they act as a cofactor of enzymes which play a very important role in various metabolic activities. So this is the two major difference between the hormones and vitamins. Then the term hormone is derived from a Greek root that is harmoi, which means to stimulate. This term is given by the scientist Bellis and Starling in 1902. Later on in 1948, the Thiamine, she suggested using the term that is the phytohormone for the hormone of plant. So phyto means plant and hormones mean the plant which are synthesized, the hormones which are synthesized in the plant, or the hormone that is stimulus which are synthesized in the plant. So it is called as a phytohormone. So phytohormones means the phytohormones are the organic substances produced naturally by the plants and which are active in minute or in very low concentration, which increase, decrease or modify the growth and development of the plant. So phytohormones, they are naturally synthesized in the plant and they are active in very minute quantities. When they are in minute concentration, they increase, decrease or modify the growth and development of the plant. So these phytohormones also term as that is the growth hormones, growth promoting substances, growth regulator or growth factors. Then plant growth regulator. So plant growth regulators refers to natural or synthetic substances which influence the growth and development of a plant. So it is called as a plant growth regulator. There are two examples. That is first one, that is the IAA, that is indoor acetic acid. This is the example of auxin. So both they are exist in both the form. They are exist in natural form in plant, and secondly they are synthetic, means they are artificially synthesized in the laboratory. Then second one, that is IBA, that is indole-butyric acid. This is also one of the category of auxin. They are always synthetic, means they are not naturally produced in the plant. So there are two lines regarding this plant growth regulator. So all plant hormone are plant growth regulator. So whatever the plant hormones which are naturally exist in the plants, they all these plant hormones are plant growth regulators. But all plant growth regulator are not plant hormones, because in the plant growth regulator category, all the chemicals, non-nutrients chemicals, they are coming, synthetic hormones are also coming. So that's why all plant growth regulator are not plant hormones. So plant hormone is, they are naturally synthesized in the plant. Then the classification of this plant growth regulator on the their where they are produced. So first category is natural hormones, means they are naturally produced by the some tissues in the plant, and they are also called as a endogenous hormone. So they are produced inside the plant body, so it's called as endogenous, that is indole acetic acid. This is the example. Second category is synthetic hormone. So they are produced artificially and they are similar to natural hormone in their physiological activity. Therefore, they are also called as a exogenous hormone, means they are synthesized outside the plant body. Example, that is 2,4-D and NAA, that is naphthalene acetic acid. So on the another basis of classification, that is on the nature of function. So that is the growth promoting hormone, that is the, they we also called as a growth promoter. They increase the growth of plant, that is auxin, gibberellin and cytokinin. And second category, that is growth inhibiting hormones, that is we call as a growth inhibitor or growth retardant, that is they are inhibit the growth of the plant. Example, that is ABA and ethylene. So first we discuss about the auxin. So auxin, the word auxin is derived from the Greek word, that is auxin, means to grow or to increase. So auxins may be defined as growth promoting substances which promote growth along the vertical axis when applied in low concentration to the shoot of the plant. So they promote the growth of vertical axis of the plant. So that's why it is called as auxin. Then discovery of auxin. So the idea of existence of auxin was proposed by the scientist Charles Darwin in 1880. So in this book, in his books of The Power of Movement in Plants. So under these books, there are two observations they are recorded by the scientists. First, that is coleoptiles of canary grass to illuminate light and observe it to be bent towards the light. And he covered the coleoptiles tip with tin foil or cut it off and observed that the coleoptiles did not bend towards the illuminate light. So on these two observations, he concluded that some stimulus is transmitted from upper to the lower part, which is induced bending of the coleoptiles, and this transmitted stimulus is nothing but a auxin. Then occurrence and distribution of auxin. So auxin occurs universally in all plants. Where there is active growth, there is a auxin production is there. Then growing meristem and enlarging organs, there produces auxin. Shoot apex produces much auxin than the root apex. Apical bud synthesize more auxin than lateral buds. Then developing seeds contain more auxin than the mature seeds. And apical bud, they are synthesized 6 times more auxin than expanding leaves. Then this is the structure of auxin. So this is the structure of indole acetic acid, that is AAA, so which are almostly continuously produced by some tissues in the plant and also known as the endogenous growth substances. Then synthetic hormone or synthetic auxin. So synthetic auxin examples are IPA, that is indole propionic acid, IBA, indole butyric acid, NAA, naphthalene acetic acid, 2,4-D, 2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid, 2,4-5-T, trichlorophenoxyacetic acid. Then effect of different auxins on plant growth and development. So cell elongation and cell division. So cell, particularly this cell elongation and cell division, they are produced the effect of auxin. So causes the growth in coleoptiles and stem due to the elongation of already existing cells. So the main causes of cell elongation, that is by increasing the osmotic content, permeability of cell to water and wall synthesis, by reducing wall pressure, by inducing the synthesis of RNA and protein, which in turn lead to increase in cell wall plasticity and extension. So these are the main causes of cell elongation. Then auxin also induces or promote the cell division within the cambial region. Then another effect, that is the apical dominance. So apical or terminal buds of many vascular plants are very active, while the lateral buds remain inactive. So this activeness is because of presence of auxin. So removal of apical bud promotes lateral buds to grow. So apical dominance is due to much higher auxin content in the apical buds than the lateral buds. So when you can remove the apical buds, the lateral bud starts to grow. Then phototropism. So plant bend towards the uninatural light. So this is due to the higher concentration of auxin on the shaded side. So this phototropism is because of the presence of auxin in the plant. Then geotropism. So movement of plant's organ in response to gravity is known as geotropism or gravitopism. So stem and roots accumulate IA, that is indole acetic acid, on the lower side in response to gravity. So in case of the shoot, increased auxin concentration on the lower side in stems causes those cells to grow more than cells on the upper side. So that's why stem bends up against the force of gravity. So it is we called as a negative gravitropism. And in case of the roots, upper side of roots grow more rapidly than the lower side. So this ultimately these roots, they are goes towards the downward side. So this is called as a positive gravitropism. So negative gravitropism and positive gravitropism is because of presence of auxin. Then root initiation. So application of IA to cut end of a stem promotes root formation. Then control or prevention of abscission. So abscission does not occur when auxin content is high on distal end and low in the proximal end of the abscission zone. So abscission means there is a formation of that abscission zone in order to detach the flower, leaves or fruits from the main axis of the plant or from the petioles, that we call as abscission. So this abscission is prevented due to presence of auxin. Then parthenocarpy. So auxin induces parthenocarpy, that is development of fruit without fertilization or formation of seed. So this auxin promotes the parthenocarpy activity. Then callus formation. So undifferentiated mass of parenchymatous tissue is known as a callus. So callus is induced because of presence of auxin in the nutrient media. So application of IA causes cell to elongate and to form the adventitious root. Then another effect of auxin is the sex expression. So auxin induce the changing of sex ratio of flowers, that is increase the number of female flowers in case of the cucurbits in order to produce the maximum flower. Then use of auxins in agriculture. So rooting of cuttings, so application of NA in mango and IB, that is indole-butyric acid in guava, in stem cuttings causes 100% success in vegetative propagation. So that is particularly the rootings, particularly cuttings which require the rootings after their propagation through by vegetative means. So these rootings of cuttings will be 100% success by using this NA and IBA. Then seedless fruit production, that is we called as a parthenocarpy. So in case of banana, grapes, strawberry, brinjal, say 100% success to produce the seedless fruit. Then in case of grapes, application of NAA, IBA and NAA, that is naphthalene acetic acid, show the 100% success for to produce the parthenocarpic fruits. Then promotion of flowering, so application of NAA, that is naphthalene acetic acid, causes uniform flowering in pineapple, which are leading to development of uniform sized fruits. Then 2,4-D is also used to increase the femaleness in monoecious cucurbits species. Then prevention of premature dropping of fruits, that is in case of apple and cotton, the NAA is used for to premature drop of fruits. In case of citrus fruits, 2,4-D and 2,4-5-T is mainly used to control this control the premature dropping of the fruits. Then IA, IBA is most widely used in the soaking of seeds for germination to accelerate the process of germination. Then fruit setting, so 2,4-5-T is used for improved fruit setting in berries. Then thinning of flower, fruits and leaves. So 2,4-D is used for defoliation of cotton plant before ball harvesting. Then NAA is used for fruit thinning in apple. Then prevention of lodging in cereals. So 30-40% yield is lost due to the lodging because of tall varieties of the cereals. So alpha naphthalene acetamide is used to prevent the lodging in case of cereals. Then weedicide. So 2,4-D and MCP, that is methyl chlorophenoxyacetic acid, are used as a weed killer. So 2,4-D is highly toxic to broad-leaved plants for dicotyledonous weeds. So weed control is possible by using these forms of auxin. Then tissue culture, so auxin along with the cytokinin show successful callus formation, that is root and shoot differentiated, when the proper proportion of auxin and cytokinin is used to produce the plant from this explant. The next category is the gibberellins. So this gibberellins is discovered by the scientist Kurosawa, a Japanese plant pathologist, in 1928. So rice plants, they infected by the fungus, that is Gibberella fusiceri, they are shows the excessive stem elongation times of symptoms. So this symptoms is called as a Bakkeni disease of rice. So this scientist isolated the chemical from this Gibberella fusiceri fungi and name as a gibberellic acid. From this, the 80 different gibberellins are available in the market. It is start from J1 to J80 for different types of the applications, but the most commonly occurring gibberellin is the GA3, which are widely used in the agriculture sector and other sectors. Then gibberellic acid have a regulatory functions. So they are produced in the shoots apex, primarily in the leaf primordial area and the root system, and they stimulate the stem growth dramatically. So stem growth is mostly affected by the gibberellins. Then they stimulates cell division, cell elongation and both, and controls the enzyme secretion. Particularly, for example, in the cultivars, the dwarf cultivars can be treated with GA and grow to normal heights. So treated dwarf varieties treated with GA, they can be grow with normal heights, so it indicates the door spaces are with lack of normal levels of GA. Then they are also involved in overcoming dormancy in seeds and buds. Then GA is also translocates easily in the plant. They are able to move freely in both the direction, that is because they are produced not only in the shoot apex but also in the root structure. So they can be both the direction, upward and downward direction, they can be transported in the plants. Then they use commercially in the increasing fruit size of seedless grape, then stimulating seed germination and seedling growth. Then this gibberellic acid is used for promoting male flowers in cucumbers for seed production. Then they overcoming the cold treatments. So for some seeds, application of GA, they are forgoes the cold treatments, means the some seeds required to be frozen or placed in the refrigerator or in a cold temperature for a period of time before they will germinate. So this is called a cold treatment. So this cold treatment is requirement is overcome by this gibberellic acid treatment. So they are promote when the seed is soaked in gibberellic acid, the seed germination is promoted. Then next is the cytokinin. So cytokinin, the main function of the cytokinin, in the name itself, that is cytokinesis, that is a means the division of cytoplasm, and division of cytoplasm is occurs during the cell division. So the main function of cytokinin is the it promotes the cell division and found in all tissues with considerable cell division, is the part where the considerable cell division is continuously going on. So that part contain maximum cytokinin. Example, that is embryos and germinating seeds, young developing fruits. So roots supply cytokinin upward to the shoot section. So whatever the cytokinin which are synthesized in the roots, they supply cytokinin toward the upper region at the shoot area, interact with the auxin to influence differentiation of tissues. So when they are with the auxin and cytokinin, they successfully used for differentiation of tissues, or they may be used to stimulate the bud formation. Then auxin and gibberellin increase the growth mainly by increasing the cell size, or sorry, increasing the cell elongation. And growth also involves the another important process, that is the formation of cell, that is we call it the cell division. So this is also important process. So developing embryo shows the active cell division. And this particularly, so that developing endosperm, particularly liquid endosperm of coconut, we call as a coconut water or coconut milk, contains cell division causing factor. So this factor is nothing but a, that is the kinetin. So it is the one of the example of cytokinin. And similarly in the maize, that developing endosperm of that maize contain same factor, such factor, that is we call as a zeatin. So kinetin and zeatin are the examples of cytokinin, so which promote the cell division. Then as roots being to grow actively in the spring, so they produce the large amount of cytokinin, and that are transported to the shoot where they cause the dormant bud to become active and expand. So whatever the cytokinin which are synthesized during the spring in the root, so they are transported toward the upper parts, the upper dormant bud. So due to transportation of cytokinin, they become active and they expand the spring season. Then tissue cultures use cytokinin to induce the shoot development. Then cytokinin may slow or prevent the leaf senescence. So senescence is the one of the deteriorative process in the plant, that is we called as a leaf aging or leaf fall. So they can be cytokinin may prevent these leaf senescence or leaf aging. Then next plant growth regulator is the ethylene. So ethylene is categorized as a growth retardant. So ethylene particularly promotes the fruit ripening. Then it is a one of the gaseous hormone. So the action, they are in the form of gas. They are produced in the actively growing meristems of the plant, in senescing ripening or aging fruits, or in senescing flowers, or in germinating seeds, and in certain plant tissues as a response to bending, wounding, or bruising. So this is the actually site of synthesis of ethylene. So ethylene as a gas, they are diffused readily throughout the plant. Then methionine and ACC synthesis, these are acts as a precursor for synthesis of ethylene. Ethylene may promote leaf senescence and abscission. So these are also another effects of the ethylene. So increase female flowers in cucumbers because of ethylene, they will increase the fruit production. So degraining of oranges, lemons and grapefruit, particularly ethylene gas breaks down the chlorophyll and lets color show through. So particularly degraining of orange and lemons, they are carried out through by ethylene treatment. Then abscisic acid, so this is also called as a growth retardants. They induce the stomatal closing and inhibition of bud growth and shoot formation. So abscisic acid, they are widely spread in plant body, they are moves readily throughout the plant, and ABA appears to be synthesized by the leaves. They interacts with the other hormones in the hormone in the plant, and they are counteracting the growth promoting effects of the auxin and gibberellin. This abscisic acid is also involved with the leaf and fruit abscission, that is leaf fall or fruit fall. Onset of dormancy in seeds, when there is a seed dormancy, there is a synthesis of ABA, and onset of dormancy, that is the rest period in perennial flowers and shrubs. So when there is a dormancy, the synthesis of ABA is increased. Then ABA is effective in inducing the closure of stomata in leaves and indicating a role in the stress physiology. So in plants, so increase in ABA following water, heat and high salinity traced to the plant. So ABA is the hormone which control the transpiration process, so that's why the stress tolerance activity is because of presence of is ABA. So this is the structure of ABA. So today we discuss about the plant growth regulators, what is the definitions, then what are the five broad categories, that is auxin, gibberellin, cytokinin, ethylene and abscisic acid, what is their role and what is their effect. So this is about all the plant growth regulator. So you have any doubt regarding this topic, so you may can ask, you can make comment, and you can also message. Thank you.